Around 3/4 of the CO2 emission reductions needed to meet global climate goals depend on technologies that are not yet fully developed. To stay on track with the Paris Agreement, we must reach net zero CO2 emissions by mid-century. Yet, global emissions were around 40 gigatons last year. This means we urgently need to speed up innovation across a wide range of technologies, from solar panels and heat pumps to electric vehicles and green steel. But there's no one-size-fits-all solution. These technologies differ in how advanced they are, what materials and infrastructure they need, and which industries and people are involved. So, how can better data-driven insights and models on energy innovation help us understand what works and what's needed to scale these technologies in line with climate goals? I'm Kavita Sorana, a professor at the WEU Institute for Data, Energy and Sustainability. In two recent studies, we explored how data on technologies, startups and investors can reveal which innovations could grow and what that growth would mean for climate and energy goals. We focused on climate tech startups, young companies working on clean energy solutions. These startups are key to innovation, but often struggle to survive or attract long-term investment. In our first study, we looked at who invests in climate tech startups. Public funding is essential early on. Programs like EU's European Innovation Council provide millions in grants. But long-term success often depends on private capital. We found that corporate investors, especially those with a strategic interest in clean energy, like utilities, oil and gas companies, or automakers, can make a big difference. These are companies that use or produce energy as part of their core business. Unlike traditional venture capital, corporations bring more than money. They offer industry knowledge, supply chains, and real-world experience. Startups that received both public funding and corporate investment were 155% more likely to succeed, compared to 78% for those with other private investors. This shows that corporate involvement can significantly boost the chances of climate tech startups bringing innovative technologies and climate solutions to the market. As policymakers and companies increase the support for climate tech, our research shows that strategic coordination is essential. Without effective public-private financing mechanisms, enabled through co-investment platforms or innovation alliances, many promising technologies risk falling into the valley of death, where early-stage technologies often fail to scale. But what about technologies that are still very new? So new that we don't yet know how well they'll work. In our second study, we looked at direct air capture with carbon storage, or DACCS, a system that removes CO2 directly from the air and stores it underground. While cutting emissions at the source is still essential, carbon removal technologies like DACCS could help us reach net zero. Though still early stage, DACCS is gaining attention. The EU has recognized its role in reaching climate targets, and some companies are signing contracts to buy captured carbon, betting on its success. To understand how DACCS might scale, we analyzed data on current startups and announced capacity. We identified similar technologies from the past to see how DACCS might grow in the future. We modeled its growth in GCAM, a tool that links energy, the economy, and climate systems to understand what that would mean for climate goals. For example, solar panels are mass-produced and grew quickly with strong policy support. If DACCS grows like solar, it could remove up to 5 gigatons of CO2 per year by 2050. But natural gas pipelines require more customization and infrastructure, which can be slow due to land and permit issues. If DACCS needs similar infrastructure and grows at that pace, it might only remove 0.2 gigatons, making it far less impactful. These comparisons helped us understand not just what's possible, but what's likely and what kind of support is needed. While predicting technology adoption is never certain, it's far from guesswork. By using historical technology trends and real-world data from today's startups, we can identify the policy conditions that help technologies grow. In short, our research connects data on startups, funding, and technology to big-picture models of energy, the economy, and climate, giving us clearer answers on what works to reach climate goals. It helps policymakers and businesses ask the right questions. It's not enough to look at whether a given technology could scale or not. It's also necessary to look at what it takes to help a technology grow.